not just because of what is happening with people in Flint, but how could so many people not have responded? That, you know, to me, I understand why Snyder, the governor, didn't tell. I cannot, for the life of me, I'm a university professor in my own life. University of Michigan changed its water. It didn't tell anyone. General Motors, all those people online saw what was happening right in front of them, and they didn't tell anyone. And that is what's happened to us. That we are so disconnected from each other that if I can save my little bottle of water from me, I don't give a damn about what's happening right outside the store. And that's humanity we have to address. I am really not concerned about Snyder's humanity. I think he saw that a long time ago. But the rest of us, that's what I'm concerned about. And I think that diminishment is something that is particularly American right now. Mm-hmm. You know, I look at many of you in this room have lived most of your life with our nation at war. And how often do we think about that? I watch these women from Flint testify. And I saw U.S. congressmen asking wonderful questions of Snyder. And I said, what if those had been Palestinian mothers? What if those had been Iraqi mothers? It would have been the same words. And they would never have had that hearing. How did we come to be so small? That's, I think, what Grace was pushing us for, to see that connection. That's a big, that's where we are in the world. That's our time now.
I want to uplift something else along those lines, which is the whole time we were watching the movie, which I don't know if you had, but we were just saying we haven't seen the movie since Grace Joined Ancestors. Have you?
No, not since then.
So we were just, you know, the whole time watching it, and I kept looking back at both of them because the other person in this film who recently joined the Ancestors just a month after Grace is Ron Scott. And we kept looking at each other whenever Ron would come up on the screen. Because it's you know, they're up there hanging with Jimmy right now. So and what Ron was very passionate about and him and Gloria House and many others were part of the Detroit Coalition Against Police Brutality. And one of his programs that he was most passionate about was this concept of peace zones for life. And the concept of peace zones for life is something that I've heard is being practiced here in this space, which is ways to address community conflict and community tensions and even violence at times with no or minimal involvement of police in the state. And that's something that you know, Ron was very passionate about and developing. And I think on my block, I've been trying to figure out like how to build relationships with people on my block so that we can call on each other. And that's a very like long-term goal, right? To build those relationships so people even have trust to call on each other as things arise and to have that foundation in place. But to become more human to me means to like not outsource things that need to come from our deep relationships to one another, you know? And that's like a thing like, you know, I have a conflict and I'm gonna outsource that to the state to now come in and obviously all of us know, come in and often murder our folks or lock up our folks and escalate whatever the conflict was in the first place. And so what is the opportunity for us to figure out in community with each other, collectively, ways to address conflict and tension, and it's something that technology we've always had, you know, to address challenges and conflict without those state finance means.
I think it's coming back to the table. You know, we get a lot of practice with that. And, you know, I mean, it's been an emotional, challenging time. We lost two board members, very vocal, passionate people, in a matter of months. And it's been emotional, trying to move forward, deal with the struggles in the city, deal with the emotions of for Shay, losing someone that's been in her life for 40-something years. For Ill, 15, for me, not as long, but like in very close proximity to where I live, and you know, and being tired and being sad and being frustrated and but still waking up and saying, you know what, we gotta come back to the table. We have to reimagine what today is going to look like, because it might not be the way we, you know, started off for it to be. And I mean, and that's just the relationship thing. Like, the very core of it in any relationship is like, how do you keep going back to the table? You know, and then what part of yourself are you going to bring when you go? Because as Grace would say, personal is political. You know, and so you don't, yeah, I remember when I was growing up, I used to always be told I had to check my stuff at the door. That, there's no such thing as that. You know, you, and as a matter of fact, I would rather have somebody bring all of it with them so we can work on it together. You know, and so it's really shedding that idea that you somehow have to check what your humanity, what you're dealing with, your full self, and leave some of it out there and bring some of it in here, and I just want to deal with just the best part of you. You know, no, we need to work on developing what the best part of us is, and the only way to do that is to come back to the table and bring your full self with you. And so Grace taught us that, because there would be days that she would call meetings and it's ridiculous hours, and she wanted us to read way, you know, a lot before we got here. Capacity to do that, but like, you had to show up, and you had to show up with whatever you had, and you had to work through that. And so that was a valuable thing that I personally got from having that relationship with her, and that my comrades also nurture and encourage out of me, and we work together in that way. And so that's helped with organizing, that's helped with family conflict, that's helped with outside world stuff, inside stuff. And so, yeah, how do you come back to the table?
Can I just one quick thing to add to that about this? This much I think I learned from Grace and Jimmy, and that is, you cannot do this by yourself. Even if it's just one other person, we cannot be our best selves first and then go work. It's through the work we become better.
I'm a-